Now we are discussing broad spectrum antibiotics and narrow spectrum antibiotics, means classification of drugs based on spectrum of activity. So what is mean by broad spectrum antibiotic? Broad spectrum antibiotic means in addition to suppression of gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria, they also inhibit the growth of other microorganisms like rickettsia, chlamydia, mycoplasma, protozoa. So we call them as a broad spectrum antibiotics like tetracycline, chloramphenicol, clindamycin, cephalosporin. So basically these are the broad spectrum antibiotics. Broad spectrum antibiotics means they inhibit the growth of gram-positive as well as gram-negative. And apart from gram-positive and gram-negative, they also inhibit the growth of other microorganisms like rickettsia, chlamydia, mycoplasma, protozoa. And what are the examples? Tetracycline, chloramphenicol, clindamycin. Narrow spectrum means they inhibit the growth of only gram-positive or they inhibit the growth of only gram-negative. For example, penicillin G, they have a very narrow spectrum activity. Narrow spectrum means penicillin G is effective against only gram-positive. Penicillin goes with positive. Penicillin G effective against only gram-positive. And aminoglycosides, they are effective against gram-negative. G goes with aminoglycoside. Aminoglycoside, they are effective against gram-negative and penicillin G is effective against gram-positive. So they have very narrow spectrum of activity. But in clinical practice, we use the term wide spectrum antibiotic. Wide spectrum antibiotic means for those effective against gram-positive and gram-negative. Gram-positive and gram-negative. And for example, ampicillin, which is effective against gram-positive and gram-negative, so we call it as a wide-spectrum antibiotic.